Well, hello everyone. I hope you had a great week, and it's good to see you here. Last week was an awesome week when we celebrated the resurrection, Easter, and I hope you had a great time with your family because that is a time for family. And now, especially with the coronavirus going on, and I hope that you've been spending more time together with your family and doing great things together. And also, sort of slowly and especially preparing for your classes, doing online classes. And remember, don't slack off. Don't slack off, okay? But do whatever you can the best way you can, okay? So, after this, we're gonna go into the worship part, and I hope that you remember the song from last week, Oh Happy Day. So check this out, and remember, you have to stand up, you have to stand up, all right? You have to stand up, you have to follow the dance, you have to follow the moves, and everything is very easy. All right, so I'll see you soon.
Jesus is alive. Empty cross, the empty grave. Life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive.
Wow, that was great. I think for me, that's one of the best songs. I really like it, and yeah, especially also the dance moves are very simple. And remember to go back, watch it again, follow it through, and next time I see you, we're gonna do it all together. And I want it'll be great when everybody knows the moves and everyone can do it together. All right, so we're gonna go into a Bible reading, and I hope that you got your Bibles. We are going to read Hebrews chapter 3, verse 4. All right, one more time. Hebrews chapter 3, verse 4.
Every house is built by someone, but God is the builder of everything. Hebrews 3:12. Amen.
Alright, let's read Hebrews chapter 3, verse 4. We're reading from the ESV version. Are you ready? Right, it says, "For every house is built by someone, but the builder of all things is God." One more time. "For every house is built by someone, but the builder of all things is God." Awesome. Now, we are going to go into Hebrews chapter 3. And today, after the awesome, awesome Bible reading of Hebrews chapter 3, verse 4. Now, remember, you have to go back, read it again and again and again and again and again. Is that today, I want to talk about God the Builder. God the Builder. Now, for me, one of the greatest shows, let's just say, I won't say it in forever, but that I really enjoyed was Bob the Builder. You know, Bob the Builder. I knew Bob the Builder, this show, I think it's been, so long ago, really. The picture I just showed you, that was the new Bob the Builder. But there was an older Bob the Builder, they tried to change it because, well, what is fun for me, it was fun for me, and now it's you guys, and you have to enjoy Bob the Builder, but with new graphics, new style. But Bob the Builder was so cool because he had friends. He had friends who were machines, and he went around. He helped people to fix buildings. And also, there's one episode where he and the big machines were building a huge reservoir, which a reservoir is like a dam full of water to help people drink. And so, like, the water you get at home in your tap, guess what? That comes from the reservoirs, and the water will go through the pipes and to everybody. You see, so Bob the Builder was helping to build his reservoirs, and so it's a great show. If you have time, go watch it. You will learn a lot and also appreciate builders. All right, it's quite awesome. Now, one thing is this, especially when you read Hebrews, is that everything that we see, all the wonderful buildings and awesome things, were built by someone. You can think of really big and tall buildings and even huge statues like the Statue of Liberty, huge towers, even Busan Tower, and also in Korea, like the Namsan Tower, and all those big things. Someone built them, right? And now also in the world, there are so many like really awesome buildings, like these ones, the really big and different designs, and each building is quite different and quite unique. And so each building is basically created and built for whatever purpose. So to know and to appreciate these buildings, you have to sort of look around, even right now. No, not really right now, but later, even outside the window, you can look outside your window and you can see all the different buildings. Try to see how many different buildings you can find, because even apartment buildings, some of them might look similar, but if you're staying in an apartment, maybe where you live, all the buildings might look similar, but then further on, you find different apartments that look different, and even inside they're different, right? Some are smaller, some are larger, some have two bedrooms, some have got three bedrooms, and some even one bedroom. You know, it's all different. And so to look at the city and say, wow, so many different buildings and people created all of this. And it's good then to really appreciate them. But here's the thing, question. What do you think a builder needs to build? Do you know? What do builders need to build? What kind of things do builders need in order to build wonderful buildings, right? This is a very important question. Well, one thing that builders need is knowledge, right? It's knowledge. They need to know how to build. They need to have all the knowledge of building. They need to have learned also how to build, because you cannot find someone's build like, I'm gonna build a house. How are you gonna do it?
I don't know. I'll ask my mommy. You know,
they have to know. They have to have learned. They must have knowledge. They must have read. They must have the drawings. And the second that they need is skills. Skills. They must know how to build. They must have the skills. You know, it's like, you know, some people, like I think maybe like you, maybe you are very good to in your making paper art, right? I can make paper art because I haven't learned how to do it properly. I can make a plane and a hat, and that's all there is really. But otherwise, no. But I'm sure you can make flowers and dragons and all of those things. And you have the skill. People have different skills. And so also builder must have good skills, must know how to build, right? And also, let me see, what else do builders need? Oh yeah, to build, of course you need what? The right tools. You need to have the right tools. All the proper tools for building. Now, if you know, that's why, even if you, for example, if you watch Bob the Builder, right? All right, Bob the Builder has friends, and so all, and like the friends are like a digger, or you know, all these huge machines, and also little ones as well. But he always carries a tool belt and also a toolbox full of different tools. And every time he needs to fix something, guess what? He takes out the right tool. All right. So to take out the nails and screws, you don't use a hammer. All right. You use a proper screwdriver and all of those things, and each one with different sizes. So you need the right tools to build huge things. You need proper buildings. That's why next time, if you go away the building, try to see how many different machines are there, just to either to break things down, or to build and to carry big things. That's why it's so noisy, because so many machines like that, right? So right tools. So knowledge. All right, first you need what? Knowledge, right? Second, you need skills. Third, you need tools, right tools. And fourth, of course, you need what? Right materials. Right materials. And so if you want to build something very big and strong, guess what? You have to use right materials. You don't use paper or something very soft. You use big metal things and bricks and all the strong things. For making a paper plane, you don't use bricks and stones, right? Now use what? Paper, something light, so that it can fly off very nicely. So these are the things that people need, and you have to use the right materials so that whatever you're making, it's good. And so the builders, otherwise, if they use very weak materials, then the building will look right. But you need to big, nice, big, strong building, which is quite awesome. So, but what about God? God is the builder too, right? God is the builder. God is the one also who built many things, right? So the question, of course, is what did God build? What kind of things did God build? Now, I think you know many things, right? So, all right, just think, okay, what kind of things did God build? Tell me, right? Let me tell me. What kind of things? All right, okay. The world. Good. God created the world. And what else? Right. Dogs. That's cool. Dogs is good. And what else? Cockroaches. Who said cockroaches? Well, yeah, but... Okay, yeah. God made cockroaches too. Yeah, and rats. Yeah, and worms. Okay, yeah, fine. Yeah. So all of these things. So you guys are funny. All right, so God created what? The world and nature. And look at all the landscape. This is called landscape, right? The landscape. God made the landscape. You know, got trees and flowers and mountains and valleys and waterfalls and dams. So wonderful and beautiful. Now also, God made, where are you? God made even flowers and insects. And everything is so good and special, right? Everything is so good and special. And everything that God made is so detailed. If you look at the flowers, next time you take the flower, just go look at the flower. The flower, just the pattern is, and the colors and everything is so nice and beautiful. Oh, and then you smell like, ooh, and everything else. No, not stink bugs. All right. Stink bugs, they don't have good smell, but everything is so good and detailed. Beautiful patterns, beautiful colors, beautiful shapes, and it's so awesome. And right, and also when you look at the waves and the ocean and the waters and the sunrise and the sunset and everything mixing together to create a very beautiful picture. And every day it is a beautiful picture. So God is like a builder, and also God is like an artist, and everything mixed together so that we could enjoy everything that he made. Right? Now all of these things are just so awesome. But of course, do you know what the best thing is? Do you know what's the best thing that God made? Do you know? I'll give you a hint. Right, this is big. It's like so big. And it's like wonderful. It's like, wow. Even the angels were like, wow, Deba. Right. What did God make? That's so awesome. Well, God made you. Yeah. Really. And so all the different things you have, and you know, however you look, maybe you got straight hairs, maybe you got curly hair, maybe you have dark skin, light skin, whatever. This is so beautiful because God made you to be special, you know. And you and in the world and creation, it's just the best, awesome thing ever. All right. And so it's very important that never, ever forget when you wake up in the morning, you just say, thank you, good morning, God. And then you look at yourself, you know, morning glory, your hair goes and saliva going down your cheek, and you just go, good morning, you. Right? Just good morning, you. Right? So you love yourself because you are precious. That's the main thing. Don't ever, ever forget that. So quickly, I also have mentioned 3 points before I let you go. Right, so three main points. Point number one is this. Where are you? Right, point number one. Bring it here. God built and also God keeps all things. Right, God is the creator of all things. God built and he keeps all things. So God is the one who created everything, right? He created everything, but also he keeps it. That's why the world just goes just like that. No, but he keeps everything. He's the one who brings the rain. He set up everything, the whole system on earth to make sure there's rain and water and sunshine and plants grow. And when things die, there's some things that comes and replace it. And it's all a wonderful circle of life. Yeah, I've been watching too much Lion King. Yeah. So the whole thing of the circle of life, that is what God created. And he built everything and he keeps everything good and fresh. Right? Now also with you, God created you and God will keep you. All right? God created you and God will keep you. Now there's also a second point is this. God can provide everything we need. Right? God can provide everything we need because, well, he created everything. He knows what you need. All right? So God created everything and he can provide everything we need. God created me. He knows what I need. And so I'm happy and confident that God will provide for me. Provide is he will give me everything I need, you know, food, shelter, clothes, friends, and all of those things I need, God can provide. So I'm happy because God is the builder and also God is also my father. Right, last point is very important. Everything God makes has a purpose. Everything God makes has a purpose. Now remember the different buildings I showed you. Even when you look outside, you can see all the different buildings, and each one has a reason, has a purpose. Why did the builders build them? Because, well, simply because they have a purpose. Why did God create you? Because you have a purpose, and that purpose is also to show the goodness of God, to show the love of God, and to show the light of God. Show God's goodness, God's love, God's light. All right, in everything we do, if you're studying, you do your best and show God's goodness and God's love and God's light. All right, so that's why. All right, so remember, have a great week. I love you guys and see you next week. God loves you, God builds you, and God will take care of you. All right, and everybody, see you. God bless and bye bye.